Hey, fascinating case involving the workplace. A waiter in New York City was fired back in 2011 after calling his boss a bunch of bad names on Facebook. And they finally got a ruling in the case. And we're joined by our legal analyst, Paul Harding from Martin Harding and Mazzotti. Hey, Paul.
Hey, good morning, guys.
So, I mean, if you look at this quickly, it's like, oh, I guess you can call your, you know, drop F-bombs on your boss and keep your job. But that's not necessarily the case.
You know, it's just not the case at all. In fact, so in New York, we're at what they call an at-will state. Now, we can be fired for anything or nothing at all. You can just walk in and say, you know, he's not feeling it today, and fire an employee. You can't do so if you're attacking them for their race or their creed or their age. But other than that, just get rid of them. But here, they were in the process of putting together a union, and there are just special rules when there's a union being put together. There's protected speech, and this speech was extreme, but the court found protected.
What's interesting about this case, though, is that the language was probably the worst you could possibly come up with. But that also the lawsuit also included that was the part of the working environment that the bosses often use the same language. And that language wasn't necessarily grounds for dismissal because their bosses use the same words.
Yeah, so we had a culture here of this language being used and calling people idiots and, you know, why are you this, and dropping, as they call it, the proverbial F-bomb. So, sure, I think that gave additional latitude where in other facilities, other offices, you might never hear those words. It might have been more extreme. But again, without the National Labor Relations Act, specific act that says once you're in the process of unionizing, really special rules apply. But anyone else tries this, as they say, don't try this at home, you know, approach. Don't try this one at the office to see if you are falling into that protected speech, because you won't be.
Well, let me ask you a question. I worked at a place that was union, and there were some, you know, issues between union and management. There was picketing and flyer distribution, all sorts of stuff. And some of the people who were the most active were also let go for, quote unquote, you know, various reasons. We all know it was because of the union activity, but they use some other excuse as a reason to terminate them. So could employers get around the union activity that way?
Well, they tried for a long time, and they got stung pretty good fairly recently. So it could almost work the opposite way. If you're that tough union person and you're kind of organizing and you're the most vocal, you probably have bought yourself some. Your work product can probably diminish, and you probably have protected yourself a little bit further. So
you've always seen that
time,
too.
Yeah, the time when that was true. And right now, I think it's the exact opposite. So, yes, absolutely so.
So if you're in the middle of a union effort or whatever, or maybe you're a union steward, you'd have to do something pretty extreme to get fired, is what you're saying. Even more extreme than speech.
I think that the bar for your work product is lowered a little bit simply because the perception will be, wow, we fired him because, right, or fired her because. So, yeah, you know, again, not a strategy you ever want to employ to test that out. But, yeah, employers are very fearful of letting someone go when there's just even a hint or a flavor that it could be because they are a vocal union advocate.
Yeah, so someone reading this story shouldn't go, oh, I've got free license to call my boss some 12-letter swear words.
Exactly, yeah. I would say that would be very bad advice.
Yeah.
One point clear, only during union activity, and probably these words only because, Kel, you pointed out aptly, it was the culture in that workplace.
Paul Harding, our legal analyst from Martin Harding Mazzotti, 1-800-LAW-1010. Thank you, Paul.